every day when you're walking down the street. Everybody that you meet has an original point of view. And I say, hey, hey, what a wonderful kind of day. If you could learn to work and play and get along with each other. You got to listen to your heart, listen to the beat, listen to the rhythm of the street. Open up your eyes, open up your ears, get together and make things better by working together. It's a simple message and it comes from the heart. Oh, believe in yourself, for that's the place to start.
Start and I say, hey, hey,
what a wonderful kind of day.
In this closet.
You think you got a headache? Listen to that snore!
Like a dump truck without a muffler!
No, my aching head!
I asked you nicely. Don't make me come out there.
Ever have one of those nights when you couldn't sleep because of the monsters under your bed and in your closet?
Come on out here, I dare ya!
Oh, you hit me! I'm going to give you such a pinch!
Come and get me, chicken!
Come out from under that bed, scaredy cat.
Night Fright.
The hills are alive with the smell of burgers.
And they're all mine. Yeah.
Yelling in your sleep.
That was the worst nightmare I ever had. I didn't even get a chance to eat anything.
But you haven't had a nightmare since we got you that nightlight.
No wonder. It's not plugged in.
Oh, yeah. I bumped it when I was playing, but I was too scared to go plug it in the dark. Mom, Dad, you would never tell anyone, would you?
Tell anyone what?
That I sleep with a nightlight.
Why would that matter, honey?
It'd matter, believe me.
We won't say a word. Now go to sleep.
Okay.
Then it slammed shut. Bam! And could never be opened again.
What's she talking about?
That first scare your pants off video.
the lunchbox of Notre Dame.
That's the scariest thing I ever heard.
Ah!
It wasn't that scary.
Not that. I just wrecked my homework. And I have to give it to Mr. Ratburn.
Okay, that's the scariest thing I ever heard.
What a bunch of little babies. Oh, I'm so scared.
Since scary books and videos are so popular, let's talk about things that scare us. Anyone want to name something that scares them?
The roller coaster at Wonderworld.
Ventriloquist dummies. I mean, what's all that about anyway? Weird.
A spoon.
A spoon?
When it's stuck in pudding.
So?
Like in the lunchbox of Notre Dame.
What about you, Binky?
My only fear is that I might get so strong, the whole school will fall down when I shut the door. Oops. Other than that, nothing scares me. Nothing.
My mom's here. See you later.
Close that raincoat. You'll get double pneumonia.
Mom! Yahoo!
Maybe your parents forgot about you.
No, they're coming from my Aunt Lucy's house. It's pretty far.
If they don't come, you'll be alone in the empty school all night. That's my mom. Too bad. I guess you'll be here all alone.
Arthur, your mom called me. Your family has to spend the night at your aunt's because they had car trouble. So you'll be spending the night at our house. You can share Binky's room. What?
Binky's pajamas don't exactly fit you, but they'll do.
My teeth are all brushed. I'm ready for bed.
Arthur's already in your room.
What? good night.
Hey, what's that?
What?
That, in your hand.
There's nothing in my hand. See?
The other hand, behind your back.
What, this? It's, my reading lamp.
How do you read down there?
Like this.
Doesn't look very comfortable.
Hey, I don't read a lot, okay? Good night.
Hey, you forgot to turn off the light.
Oh, yeah.
Kind of scary.
Will you go to sleep?
Everybody ready to see Binky's little night white?
No! Let me out!
No! What's happening?
Oh, honey! You forgot to turn on your nightlight. There, now. You won't have any more nightmares.
I have nightmares if I don't turn a nightlight on, okay? So go to sleep.
See you, Binky. Binky sleeps with a nightlight.
What a baby!
You better not tell anyone.
Tell anyone what?
So then, the bionic bunny crashed through the wall just as the bomb was about to explode.
Okay, you win. Anything you want, pal. Those books look heavy. Let me carry them. Get out of the way. Arthur's coming through.
Hey, give me my pencil back.
I sharpened it for you, buddy.
Huh? Binky?
What do you need, Arthur? Old buddy, old pal, old chum of mine?
If you're being nice because you don't want me to tell anyone you have a nightlight, relax. I won't tell.
Wait! You're up to something. What's it gonna cost me?
Binky, I told you.
You
You can't trick me. You're waiting till I don't expect it, then wham!
Ahem. What's with Binky?
Oh, nothing.
Yesterday, we talked about things that scare us. Let's go around the room and hear ways you use to help yourself feel less afraid.
Binky has a night light. Binky has a night light.
Binky has a night light. Binky has a night light. Binky has a night light.
Oh, that's the funniest thing I ever heard!
Cemeteries scare me. So whenever I have to walk by one, I whistle.
It works! When I'm worried, I use a laser I built to shine a light on the moon. That makes me feel better. I don't know why.
When I'm nervous, I talk to my old stuffed lobster, Bob.
How do you deal with your fears, Arthur?
If he tells, everyone will laugh at me. But if he doesn't tell, I'm his slave for the rest of my life. Oh, man, what do I do now? Oh! I want to go next!
If that's okay with Arthur.
I had nightmares, but when I use a nightlight, I can get to sleep.
Good, Binky. That's a very common one. Very normal.
It is?
Yeah. Yeah, it's normal.
What are you looking at?
Hey, Arthur, wait up!
Look, about the way I've been acting, I just wanted to say...
Binky, don't worry. It's okay.
No, it's not okay. I paid for your lunch, and you've got to pay me back. And that racing car eraser I gave you, fork it over. And I gave you my dessert, and wiped that mud off your shoes, and put 3.5 drops of glue on your collage.
Good night, Sonny.
Good night, honey. You're the sweetest boy in the world.
Night, Mommy. Good night, Daddy.
Sooner or later, we're all afraid of something.
Like heights!
Ah! Or big spiders!
Ah!
But you know who's never afraid? Sue Ellen. Nothing scares her. Not oral reports.
If nobody volunteers to go first, I'll have to pick one of you myself.
I volunteer, Mr. Ratburn.
Not the daily special at the cafeteria.
Yuck!
Not even scary movies. And after what happened in the woods, she's still not easy to scare.
What about you, Arthur?
What scared Sue Ellen?
And they hear it again.
Squeak, squeak, squeak.
And man, are they scared. So they start the car and zoom, they drive off.
And then?
And then, when they get home, they find out what was making that squeaky noise. They're stuck to the car door handle is...
Yeah?
A big, sharp book.
Ah! Wait, I've heard this story before. It's supposed to be a hook stuck to the door, not a book.
I know, but where was I supposed to find a hook?
That was still scary, Binky. Weren't you scared, Sue Ellen?
Why? It's just a silly, made-up story. It didn't really happen.
We know it's make-believe.
We do?
That's what makes it fun.
Fun is traveling, sightseeing, going new places. Real things are fun. Boom!
Wow, is she tough.
Ah! trying to scare me. It's not going to
work.
Fun at school today, Sue Ellen?
Yeah, lots of fun. This is silly. There are no such things as monsters. Not here. Maybe it's something that followed us from someplace else. Someplace overseas. Like the Baba Yaga. Scary ogre lady from the Russian backwoods. There she is. Lunch. I don't like chasing my meals, little man. To me. Binky, don't do that!
So you can get spooked. Hey, we finished the scary scarecrow. Wanna see him?
No, we'll be late for school.
No, we won't. We'll take the shortcut through the dead woods.
No, thanks. Maybe later.
No, really, she was scared.
Sue Ellen's scared? Of what?
A mummy?
Nah, mummies are too slow. She could outrun one.
Not if the mummy had a mountain bike.
Nothing on Earth scares Sue Ellen. So, it's not from Earth. At last, someone's seen a real alien.
It's not aliens. It's worse.
An old lady in a house that walks like a chicken? What's scary about that?
Couldn't you just catch it and barbecue it?
Stop it! This is real!
Why? Because it's one of your stories and not ours? Did you ever see a Baba Yaga when you were in Russia?
Has Buster ever seen a space creature?
Well, no, but...
So does that mean they're not real?
It still doesn't prove it was a Baba Yaga.
I know. It could have been something else.
The creek's always noisy this time of year. It's just water.
Or it could have been a kappa.
What's a kappa?
A hungry river demon from Japan. The only way to defeat it is to make it bow.
Look, a $5 bill.
Darn, I'm stuck.
What kind of demon are you? You got to work on your defense, kid.
I'll do better next time.
Hey, the next guy might have a sword. Remember what happened to Larry?
That's how I'd handle him.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, maybe you heard a bird.
Or a banshee from Ireland. Her wail foretells doom for anyone she visits.
Huh? Ah!
Ah! Ah! Hey, the heart!
What's so hard about that? I think that was my mom calling me, so I better be going.
It was right around here.
Huh?
Ah! Beth, what is it?
An intergalactic creature of some kind. Or a chipmunk.
What do you think, Arthur?
I think I want to leave.
Go away. You don't scare me. I showed that old monster.
Any ideas, Sue Ellen?
Yeah. Run!
Wait! What are we afraid of? We didn't see anything.
No, just a...
Oh, it's just the treehouse.
We can't go on like this. We're scared of everything.
Well, we were okay until you told us all those stories.
But they're just stories.
No, you heard that thing. It's real.
But there must be a logical explanation for this. Right?
When you find out, let me know.
Join us, Sue Ellen. We're reliving our old Swiss Alps adventure.
Remember how afraid we were before we climbed our first mountain?
So, how did you get over your fear?
Once we'd prepared and had the proper equipment, we could face our fear head on.
I wasn't scared. I mean, hello?
Binky, I'm going back.
Back? Why?
We'll never be able to use the shortcut again if we don't face that thing. We just need to be prepared and have the right equipment.
Oh, man.
Let's go.
Why not?
Remember, whatever happens, don't scream.
Agreed. One for all,
and good for nothing. That's me.
Sorry.
Oh! Oops.
Oh. Hey, you guys!
It's Perky, Mrs. Wood's mean old dog.
Perky? That's what scared us?
A dog. Imagine that.
Oh, my precious Perky! I was worried sick over you. Arthur, you've saved my Perky again.
We all did.
Why, she'd still be trapped if you had let her cry frighten you away. Aren't you a brave group? I shall give you all a big kiss.
No!
It again. Scritch, scritch. It was coming from the dead woods. I saw its beady, glowing eyes. Then, from inside the ghost tree, it sprang.
What? What?
A hideous, two-headed wolfman!
Hey, you said wolfman, not cowman.
I couldn't find a wolf head.
Wow, I didn't think you liked scary stories, Sue Ellen.
Yeah, how'd you think of something so cool?
And now we're off it.
Sound can fool you sometimes. Everybody in our class made a sound.
One kid may will make a sound and the other kid will not be able to see the sound, and so they'll try to guess what the sound is.
You get it?
Are you playing a drum?
No.
Sometimes things sound different than what they really are.
Taking apart those packing materials.
No.
I have to admit that I think it's the garbage can going up and down.
Yes!
Taking tape out of the thing.
Yeah!
Pulling the cap off the glue stick.
Oh.
Two knives?
No.
Is it any kind of silverware?
No.
Sound is a vibration.
Vibration that sends waves through the air. Then it would bounce against your eardrum and your eardrum would vibrate and then you would hear a sound.
You know, your ears can trick you.
Is it sliding a box around?
No!
Scissors.
Yeah. Yeah!
Sound is very mysterious.
And now, back to Arthur!
Gotcha! Didn't I? I love practical jokes. You never know when one's going to sneak up on you. Or who might be behind it. See what I mean?
The Fright Stuff.
Mm-mm. Spaghetti. Ah! Worms, yuck.
They aren't real, Brain. They're jelly worms.
I forgot my science book. That's funny. Something stuck to it. Ah! Get it off! Get it off!
No, no.
Why? It's just a toy.
What's this?
Hey! Who are you?
Someone's scaring you guys with a few practical jokes. So what?
So what? So it's working, that's what?
And the mystery joker left these notes telling us to meet him here.
What makes you think it's a him? Maybe it's an it.
Francine!
Buster, calm down. You're acting like you just saw a monster! Wow, you guys should have seen the looks on your faces.
What's this all about?
It's about my party, silly.
What party?
The scary costume party I'm having in honor of the new Scare Your Pants Off book.
House of the Jack-o'-Lantern? Cool.
And the author, E.A. DePoe, is going to come and read it to us.
After all, she was Daddy's favorite teacher, Miss McWord. And he likes her books as much as we do. And after what you did to me on April Fool's Day, you guys are going to be my extra special guests. Ah!
Shh.
But.
She sounds like a motorboat. Extra special guests, huh? Cool. So where is this party?
Castle Manor. Daddy bought it to make it into an antique car museum.
Castle Manor? Hasn't that place been empty for over 50 years?
Yeah. Isn't it supposed to be, you know...
haunted? That's why it's perfect for a scare-your-pants-off party.
Well, you don't have to come if you're so afraid.
Really? I mean, we're not afraid of anything, right, guys?
Oh, come on!
What are you
talking to?
Oh, guys! Oh, yeah, we'll see about that.
The older I get, the more I think that there's nothing scarier than girls.
If the girls could scare us that bad at school, how are we going to make it through their party?
We won't. Unless we beat them to the scare.
How?
Easy. We know those books better than anyone. We can come up with something 10 times scarier than they can.
Yeah, like in The Thing at the Head of the Class.
Or It Came from Under the Soap Dish.
How about something really scary? Like Edgar Allan Poe's The Tell-Tale Heart.
By H.G. Wells is scarier.
Ah! Greetings, friends.
Friends? Darn pleased to meet you.
Ah! It's perfect. All we need is a real UFO, two real aliens, and... Oh, yeah. On second thought...
What about a headless horse guy, like in The Legend of Creepy Hollow?
You mean Sleepy Hollow.
Whatever.
It's the headless horse guy!
Run!
Ow!
Where have you learned to be a horse guy?
Me? I'm headless. I'm not supposed to see.
No. This is what we do. We gotta go in there and they can't really see what we're gonna do, so we're gonna go to the top of the library.
Man, that is good.
Yeah, maybe this party won't be so bad after all.
Okay, turn off the light.
How'd you do that?
They're balloons, painted with glow-in-the-dark colors. Just like the ghost rain in the book. Cool, huh?
Are we gonna scare their pants off? Hey, don't do that.
I didn't. Come on, I better tell Daddy that the lights in here need fixing.
I think we're gonna scare their pants off.
Man, I'm gonna be part of the best practical joke in history.
When are we gonna scare them?
Later, after Ms. McWord's reading. Take your seats. And may I introduce our ghost of a host, Ms. McWord. Thanks for coming, Ms. McWord. I know it's going to be fun.
Muffy, I think so too.
It's too crowded. We can't find any place to set up the scare.
I found the perfect spot. The upstairs library. Go on up.
Yeah!
Wait, where's Pinky?
We thought he was with you.
Pinky, where have you been? The guys are upstairs in the library. You can get a drink later. Get going!
Arthur! Ah! You're going to miss the story.
I was looking for you.
What for?
I heard a weird noise upstairs.
You did? Where?
In the library. Come on, I'll show you.
He's gonna walk right into our prank. It's too perfect.
And then Tony Ruchadow knew the only way to prove their bravery was to spend the night in the dreaded house of the jack-o'-lantern.
I'm sure it was in here.
Muffy, what are you waiting for?
I can't find it.
Like I said, I'm sure it was in here. Pretty cool prank, huh?
That was mean!
Yeah, and worse than that, you stole our prank!
What? No, I didn't!
Guys, did you steal their prank? Binky? Brain? Buster?
Here we are.
We have to get them to go in the playroom.
Yeah, the library was locked. We set up in the playroom.
What are you talking about? It's not locked. It worked perfectly.
We didn't do it.
There's a bunch of cool balloons in there. A needle tape recorder, too.
Did you put them in there?
Okay, Binky. What's going on?
Sorry I'm late, but I walked into the refrigerator and broke my pumpkin. Can I be a Cyclops instead?
Binky, if you just got here, then who is...
This isn't the time or place for your silly pranks.
It's not a prank, sir!
No! We were upstairs pulling a prank on the girls.
And we were pulling a prank on the boys!
Muffy, what have I told you
about playing pranks on people?
That it's mean-spirited and always comes back to haunt you.
Because when pranks get out of hand, someone could get hurt. And their feelings are sure to get hurt.
The boy asked me to help them. I just wanted to go to the party.
There are better ways to have fun.
We're sorry, but there really was a...
No more! Go have fun!
Boy, am I ever done with pranks. I don't care how much you prank me.
I'm not pranking anyone. Ever. Hey, cool costume.
Thanks. Yours is cool, too.
Oops!
And I say, hey, what a wonderful kind of day. If we could learn to work and play and get along with each other.
You got to listen to your heart, listen to the beat, listen to the rhythm on the street. It's a simple message and it comes from the heart. Believe in yourself, for that's the place to start.
And I say, hey, wonderful kind of day. We can learn to work and play and get along with each other. What a wonderful kind of day. What a wonderful kind of day.
Funding for Arthur is provided by the United States Department of Education and by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
This program is made possible in part by a grant from Libby's Juicy Juice. Juicy Juice, 100% juice for 100% kids.
And by Baby Gap.
Alphabets, 26 little letters that make the words that let you share your feelings around the corner or around the world, bringing us all a little bit closer together. Post Alphabet Cereal is proud to bring you Arthur on PBS.
PBS Kids!
Check out Arthur online at www.pbs.org. Remember, you can find Arthur books and lots of other books, too, at your local library.
Hey, it's always a wonderful kind of day when Arthur and his pals visit you and your family. Now there are even more delightful stories about this lovable aardvark, each ready for you to enjoy anytime right at home. So come and join Arthur, DW, Binky, Buster, Francine, and all their friends in these enchanting videos filled with laughter, learning, and fun.
Hey,
collect them all. The Arthur Home Video Series, including two brand new episodes.
Lost? Lost?
Arthur Gets Lost.
Who's lost?
Arthur, Daddy. He's lost, and I never got to say goodbye.
I found something.
and Arthur's treasure hunt.
It might belong to a saber-toothed tiger or a T-Rex or...
Pal, this bone belongs to Pal, Arthur.
Available now, only from Random House Home Video. And be sure to check your local stores for Arthur videos, books, CD-ROMs, and other Arthur merchandise.
Hey, what a wonderful kind of day. Hey.